Oh god. Grab that ledge, man.
You cannot run forever.
Like my grand escape. Luckily, the bureau's pretty close by. So closed on yellow.
They go against the will of God and must be made to pay. Everywhere they ride, they leave only.
You guys are far too close to the Assassin Bureau. Mind the gigantic logo on top of it. It's nothing.
Violence, madness. We must resist. We must fight them in any way we can.
It is done.
Jerusalem needs a new ruler.
So I have heard.
What's this? No words of wisdom for me? Surely I have failed in some spectacular fashion.
You performed as an assassin should. No more, no less. That you expect praise for merely doing as told, however, troubles me.
It seems everything I do troubles you.
Reflect on that. But do so on your way back to Masyaf. Your work here is done.
This guy does not like me.
Fast forwarding.
I did kill his bro. Fast travel, please. Man, if I hit no, I would kick myself so hard.
Remember to reach out for ledges should you fall while climbing.
Come, Altair. I would have news of your progress.
I've done as you've asked.
Good, good. I sense your thoughts are elsewhere. Speak your mind.
Each man I'm sent to kill speaks cryptic words to me. Each time I come to you and ask for answers. Each time you give only riddles in exchange, but no more.
Who are you to say no more?
I'm the one who does the killing. If you want it to continue, you'll speak straight with me for once.
Tread carefully, boy. I do not like your tone.
And I do not like your deception.
I have offered you a chance to restore your lost honor.
Not lost. Taken. By you. And then you've sent me to fetch it again like some damn dog.
It seems I'll need to find another. A shame. You showed great potential.
I think if you had another, you'd have sent him long ago. You said the answer to my question would arise when I no longer needed to ask it. So I will not ask. I demand you tell me what binds these men.
What you say is true. These men are connected by a blood oath not unlike our own.
Who are they?
Non nobis, domine, non nobis.
Templars.
Now you see the true reach of Robert de Sablé.
All of these men, leaders of cities, commanders of armies.
All pledge allegiance to his cause.
Their works are not meant to be viewed on their own, are they? But as a whole, what do they desire?
Conquest. They seek the Holy Land not in the name of God, but for themselves.
What of Richard, Salah ad-Din?
Any who oppose the Templars will be destroyed. Be assured they have the means to accomplish it.
Then they must be stopped.
That is why we do our work, Altair. To ensure a future free of such things.
Why did you hide the truth from me?
That you might pierce the veil yourself. Like any task, knowledge precedes action. Information learned is more valuable than information given. Besides, your recent behavior had not inspired much confidence.
I see.
Altair, your mission has not changed, merely the context within which you perceive it.
And armed with this knowledge, I might better understand those Templars that remain.
Is there anything else you want to know?
What about the treasure Malik retrieved from Solomon's temple? Robert seemed desperate to have it back.
In time, Altair, all will become clear. Just as the role of the Templars has revealed itself to you, so too will the nature of their treasure. For now, take comfort in the fact that it is not in their hands, but ours.
If this is your desire.
It is. You are restored another rank. Take back your weapon. Use it to bring honor to the Brotherhood. Altair, before you go...
Yes?
How did you know I wouldn't kill you?
Truth be told, Master, I didn't. I took a leap of faith.
What weapon are you giving back to me? Probably another gauntlet? Extra throwing knives. That poo-poo. Okay. One last guy. Please give me fast travel. Please give me a fast travel. I haven't been in Damascus for a while.
Altair, my friend. Welcome, welcome. Whose life do you come to collect today?
His name is Abu Nakut. What can you tell me about him?
Oh, the merchant king of Damas, richest man in the city. Quite exciting, quite dangerous. I envy you, Altair. Well, not the bit where you were beaten and stripped of your rank, but I envy everything else. Except for the terrible things the other assassins say about you. But yes, aside from the failure and the hatred, yes, aside from those things, I envy you very much.
I do not care what the others think or say. I'm here to do a job. So I ask again, what can you tell me about the Merchant King?
Only that he must be a very bad man if Al-Mualim has sent you to see him. He keeps to his own kind, wrapped in the finery of this city's noble district. A busy man, always up to something. I'm sure if you spend some time amongst his type, you'll learn all you need to know about him.
And where would you have me begin my search?
If I were you, I'd start with the Umayyad Mosque and Souk Saruja, both of which are west of here. Further to the northwest is Salahuddin Citadel. It's a popular meeting spot and has proved a reliable source of loose tongues in the past. Yes, these three places should serve your needs.
My thanks for your guidance, Rafiq. I'll return when I've gathered the necessary information.
This guy's so savage. Rubs that salt deep, man. Rub that salt. I swear, he sounds exactly like Leonardo. Yeah, Damascus isn't the... Well, I guess this is the poor district. So let's say this isn't the swankiest place ever, but... Who you can't feel? Jump and grab. Oh, no, grab. Oh, the ragdoll.
You, sir, you look like you need something. You'll find it here, I'm sure of it.
What? Where are you going?
I haven't done this flag challenge
in a
while.
Safety and peace. You want information about the city, I suppose? Right now, I don't have time. I must find some flags which have been stolen from our cache in the rich district of Damask. But with this heat, my legs cannot carry me anymore. Would you be kind enough to help me? Return with the flags, and I'll help you as best I can.
This guy. So lazy.
You are not supposed to be here. Leave.
How the flags? They're not labeled very well. That's such a weird sound. There we go. Flag running like a G.
Have you gone mad, Chikartajak? Didn't that catch your own?
You're a fool!
Must be on top of me somewhere. No, what the hell is it? Oh my god, there it is.
Thank you. The Rafiq will be happy to see these flags returned. Perhaps this morsel of information will help you. I was invited by Abul to one of his lavish parties. I noticed the fountain in the middle of the Merchant King's palace could be easily climbed. Use this information wisely. Now, if you'd excuse me, I must go.
Beat up interrogation mission.
There is no one more generous than Abul Nukul. Every week he opens his doors to the people of Damas, that they may lay down their burdens and no
هل هناك سبب لسلوكه الأحمق؟
Leave this place.
Praise be Abul Nukul, who saved our city from certain destruction.
You have no business here.
He spent his own coin to see us fed and clothed. He spent tend to the fires, that we might be warm.
I've done nothing wrong!
His kindness
Why are you doing this?
Everything we now have, we have because of him! That? Praise be Abul Nukult, who saved our city from certain destruction. He spent his own coin to see us fed and clothed. His men tend to the fires, that we might be warm. His kindness knows no bounds. Everything we have because of him. Praise be Abul Nukut, who saved our city from certain destruction. He spent his own coin to see us fed and clothed. His men tend to the fires that we might be warm. His kindness knows no bounds. Everything we now have because of him.
The merchant provides
for one and all. He asks for nothing in return. Let his generosity serve as an example to us all. Everyone should strive to be as he.
Oh, you're gonna walk right between the guards, aren't you? Of course you are, of course you are.
You are not supposed to be here, leave.
You like that move?
Leave
that was
now.
Slick, wasn't it? They never look up. Ever. ever to look up. You may cause a problem. Throwing knife to the chest. Perfect, right into a dead alley. Mother! No point is to hurt you, man.
I'll talk. I've no interest in dying for him. His coin's not worth my life.
A wise decision.
What is it you want?
I've business with the Merchant King.
Ha! Huh? Good luck with that. He rarely leaves his chambers.
Why? Is he afraid?
Not fear. Hate. He hates himself as much as he hates the people he pretends to serve. Locks himself away in his personal quarters out of shame.
He can't stay hidden forever.
No. Those celebrations of his. He comes out to speak, to look down upon the people. A sense of belonging, I suppose, however brief.
What's wrong with him that he would hide like this?
You'll see. Now let me go.
Let you go? So you can tell him of my plan?
I won't say a thing.
No, you won't.
We are the children of God.
Why do they always squeal? Knowing they're gonna die anyways. Grab this pickpocket mission. Ugh, whatever, fuck it, just run. Run! YOLO! Really makes me wonder, like, just replaying this game, how drastically the jump from Assassin's Creed 1 to 2 was. This was a good game, but it does get a little bit repetitive at times, and just Assassin's Creed 2 is just a fantastic game the entire way through. You and every other person in this damn city, lady. Few coins here, few coins there. Next thing you know, I'm broke. I don't have time to save you, lady. I got a mission to accomplish here.
Why could you see such a strange man?
Where's the bureau entrance up top? Stub my toe, hit a pebble.
Peace be upon you, Altair. How may I serve you?
I've done as asked and learned all I need to know about my prey.
Then you must share your knowledge with me.
Abu Naqud is corrupt to the core and despised by his own citizens as a result. It appears he's been stealing money meant for the people of Damas and spending it on himself. Even as we speak, he flaunts his greed, preparing for a lavish party. His guards and servants should have their hands full dealing with the guests. They won't even know I'm there.
Most impressive, my friend. The others said you'd make a mess of things, but not I. No, I was sure you'd come through, and come through you have. The bureau is yours to do with as you please until you're ready to begin.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
Member block 4 completo. Alright, let's go stabby. Humpy, stabby. Plot line for Game of Thrones right there. Okay. I'm so hungry I could eat at Arby's. Oh my god. She must be really hungry. This decided to reduce prices on everything. That's what you all say.
This Titan is everywhere, watching, waiting.
He's commiserating.
Strong like Salahadin.
You are oh, I think I have to go into that square.
In whatever way you can.
Ow. Breaking legs.
I stand before
no,
you.
Please don't leave. Just a few coins.
There will be no stopping him. He will march on Jerusalem next. We must
gentle push, gentle push.
Before it has a chance to begin.
He'll hurt someone at that speed.
Make no mistake. It is our very existence we are fighting for. The infidel king would see us all wiped from the world. We must resist. Oh. We must push back.
I'm in. Front entrance, blend, let's watch a video. Dang girl, look at them guns. Oh, you're covered with pus and boils.
Welcome, welcome, thank you all for joining me this evening. Please eat, drink, enjoy all the pleasures I have to offer. Take your time, I will wait. I trust everything is to your satisfaction.
Fountain of wine? Not bad.
Good, good. It pleases me to see you all so happy. For these are dark days, my friends, and we must enjoy this bounty while we still can. War threatens to consume us all. Salahadin bravely fights for what he believes in, and you are always there to support him without question. It is your generosity that allows his campaign to continue. So, I propose a toast then. To you, my dear friends, who have brought us to where we are today. May you be given everything you deserve for it.
So long as you didn't touch your finger in the wine.
Such kindness! I didn't think it in you. You, who have been so quick to judge me, and so cruel. Oh, do not feign ignorance. Do you take me for a fool? I have not heard the words you whisper behind my back. Well, I have, and I fear I can never forget. But this is not why I called you here tonight. No.
Oh, shit.
I wish to speak more of this war and your part in it. You give up your coin quick as can be, knowing all too well it buys the deaths of thousands. You don't even know why we fight. The sanctity of the Holy Land, you'll say, or the evil inclination of our enemies. But these are lies you tell yourselves. No, all this suffering is born of fear and hate. It bothers you that they are different, just as it bothers you that I am different. Compassion, mercy, tolerance. These words mean nothing to any of you, mean nothing to those infidel invaders who ravage our land in search of gold and glory. And so I say enough! I've pledged myself to another cause, one that will bring about a new world in which all people might live side by side in peace.
Guys, like, don't touch me.
A pity none of you will live to see it.
Yeah, he poisoned the wine. Good thing I don't drink on duty.
Kill anyone who tries to escape.
Ow. long arrows.
Your life is now.
Can I air assassinate you from here? Nope. But I still gotcha.
Be at peace now. Their words can no longer do harm.
Why have you done this?
You stole money from those you claim to lead. Sent it away for some unknown purpose. I want to know where it's gone and why.
Look at me. My very nature is an affront to the people I ruled. And these noble robes did little more than to muffle their shouts of hate.
So this is about vengeance, then?
No, not vengeance, but my conscience. How could I finance a war in service to the same god that calls me an abomination?
If you do not serve Salah ad-Din's cause, then whose?
In time, you'll come to know them. I think perhaps you already do.
Then why hide? And why these dark deeds?
Is it so different from your own work? You take the lives of men and women, strong in the conviction that their deaths will improve the lots of those left behind. A minor evil for a greater good? We are the same.
No, we are nothing alike.
Ah, but I see it in your eyes. You doubt.
Yeah.
Cannot stop us. We will have our new world.
Run away! Praise be to Saladid! Okay, I gotta find a way out of here. Up. Top. Come on, keep climbing up. There's my exit. Thank you, sir. Now run like the wind. Again, blasting through these missiles, man.
Word has reached me of your success, Altair.
Abu Nakud's reign of terror is at an end.
I'm glad to hear it.
He killed them, the men and women at his party. It was poison, a coward's tool. Blamed them for the war. Said he wished to end it.
Strange, but then again, the merchant king was known to be a bit different. Perhaps this was simply a symptom of his madness.
Perhaps.
You sound unconvinced. Speak with Al-Mualim then. He may offer a better explanation.
Yes. We'll see what he has to say.
Back to Masyaf.
To a more recent one.
Yeah, we were in there for a while.
We done already?
Get up.
Whatever you say, Doc.
I'm ending the session. I'll be right there. You're sure about this?
Yes.
No. Everything's Denver. I don't see how he could... Of course. I understand. You're in a lot of trouble, Mr. Miles.
What's his problem?
They're coming for you.
Who's coming for me?
Assassins.
Hey, I had nothing to do with this.
Sounds like they're mounting some kind of rescue attempt. Guess you're more important than you realized.
Man, things just keep getting weirder and weirder around here.
It was bound to happen.
What do you mean?
That little fight your ancestor started during the Third Crusade, it never ended. You're being held by Templars.
Vidic's a Templar?
There's no way you could have known. They hide it so well. But to answer your question, Vidic works for them. We all do. Abstergo is their company.
I thought Templars were old dudes with funny hats who sat around drinking beer and plotting world domination with, like, the lizard people.
No. Except the part about world domination, I guess. Look, Desmond, it's complicated. Half the stuff they say about the Templars comes from crazy tinfoil hat-wearing nutjobs. The other half is misinformation intentionally produced by the Templars themselves.
But they are the bad guys, right?
If there's one thing I've learned since I started working here, it's that there's no such thing. It's all so relative. I guess the best way to explain it is, what they want is good, but the way they're going about it, it's bad. Really bad.
What are they trying to do? Lucy.
Yes.
That's rude.
Miss Stillman, I need to speak with you. Get up here, now.
On my way, Doctor. I'm sorry, Desmond, I have to go. You should turn in for the night. The answers to all of your questions are right in front of you. You just have to know where to look.
Hint, 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 hint. Let's go back to our room. Go to your room. Show me something here.
Missed you this morning, Doc.
Get in the Animus.
Jesus. How about a please? You say please. Someone pissed in his coffee this morning. In we go.
Lie down, dammit.
Jesus.
Use throwing knives to deal with distant enemies.
Come in, Altaïr. I trust you're well rested? Ready for your remaining trials?
I am, but I'd speak with you first. I have questions.
Ask then. I'll do my best to answer.
The merchant king of Demas murdered the nobles who ruled his city. Mejdedin in Jerusalem used fear to force his people into submission. I suspect William meant to murder Richard and hold Akka with his troops. These men were meant to aid their leaders. Instead, they chose to betray them. What I do not understand is why.
Is the answer not obvious? The Templars desire control. Each man, as you've noted, wanted to claim their cities in the Templar name, that the Templars themselves might rule the Holy Land and eventually beyond. But they cannot succeed in their mission.
Why is that?
Their plans depend upon the Templar treasure, the Peace of Eden. But we hold it now, and they cannot hope to achieve their goals without it.
What is this treasure?
It is temptation.
It's just a piece of silver.
Look at it.
What am I supposed to see?
This piece of silver cast out Adam and Eve. It turned staves into snakes, parted and closed the Red Sea. Eris used it to start the Trojan War, and with it a poor carpenter turned water into wine.
It seems rather plain for all the power you claim it has. How does it work?
He who holds it commands the hearts and minds of whoever looks upon it, whoever tastes of it, as they say.
Then Gagne's men?
An experiment. Herbs used to simulate its effects, to be ready for when they held it.
Talel supplied them. Tamir equipped them. They were preparing for something. But what?
War.
And the others, the men who ruled the cities, they meant to gather up their people, make them like Gagne's men.
The perfect citizens, the perfect soldiers, a perfect world.
Robert de Sablé must never have this back.
So long as he and his brothers live, they will try.
Then they must be destroyed.
Which is what I've had you doing. There are two more Templars who require your attention. One in Akka, known as Sibran. One in Damas, called Jubair. Visit with the Bureau leaders. They'll instruct you further.
As you wish.
Be quick about it. No doubt Robert de Sablé is made nervous by our continued success. His remaining followers will do their best to expose you. They know you come, the man in the white hood. They'll be looking for you.
They won't find me. I'm but a blade in the crowd.
Here, my gift to you, in gratitude for the good work you've done.
The real sword of Altaïr. Yeah. Fancy sword work. Defense break. Oh, you're not gonna have me practice it? Alright. Let's see here. Fast travel, please. Go to Acker. Hero.
Countering a strong attack will leave your enemy vulnerable. Finish him by breaking his legs or by throwing him to the ground.
Okay. So two more, and then I think we'll reach the end point. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, that's actually going to be it for me for this session. I got to take a quick break. So thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the return of Assassin's Creed. I don't think we have too much more of the game left. As always, if you enjoy, drop the video a quick thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. As always, have a nice day.